mean, words really can't describe on how I feel about Bernard Hopkins, not only for what he's accomplished inside the ring, but what he's accomplished outside the ring. So this fight was relatively easy to make, because when you have two top caliber fighters, either side doesn't hesitate to make a good fight happen. So it is my pleasure to introduce to you the president and CEO of Star Boxing, who represents Joe Smith Jr., and he is my good friend, Joe De Guardia. Joe.
Thank you, Oscar. It's certainly a pleasure to be here in California, LA Forum, where so much history has taken place in this sport. I want to thank Oscar, thank Golden Boy Promotions, and Oscar's right. This fight was relatively easy to make, and that's a testament to Bernard Hopkins. You know, most people would shy away from a puncher like Joe Smith in their last fight. But I actually knew Bernard was gonna do it, because he's like a fly attracted to that fire or whatever it might be. But it's an honor, and I thank Bernard for taking this and Oscar. Pleased to be on HBO, great network of boxing, and it's gonna be a spectacular night on December 17th. You know, Bernard is the kind of guy that you look at and say, four decades he's been in the sport, the 80s, the 90s, I mean, four decades. It's really something special. And I look sometimes, I point at Bernard and tell my kids, look at the kind of shape, because they tell me I'm out of shape now. So I say, you know, listen, 52's not that bad. All right? You can still be in shape. But Bernard was fighting in the 80s. I was boxing in the 80s. I don't see myself getting back into that ring now. So it's really something special. But he really picked probably too dangerous of an opponent. And as much as I talk to my kids about the discipline about Bernard, I also respect and honor Joe Smith. He's the quintessential guy that America could look at. He's the guy that's out there every morning, 9 o'clock in the morning, out there with that sledgehammer, the jackhammer. He's a laborer. He still works. Okay, up until the time when I called him to tell him that he's going to fight Bernard Hopkins, he's a union laborer and was working. That day he actually told his boss, I'm going to go home and run, because I got the Bernard Hopkins fight. But it's something when you have two guys that you can really respect. Bernard, for all he's done in this sport, the discipline he's shown as a man inside and outside the ring, and Joe Hopkins, who is the quintessential American. Really.
How do you like that?
How do you like that? So.
Sounds good.
You like that? That's because I anticipate that he's going to be taking the page from your book. And for the next three decades, I'm going to have him on top of the world. But truthfully, it's really an honor. Joe Smith is a really true working man. And a lot of the people really look at that, and it resonates with the people. He's who people can look towards and say, wow, look at this guy. Gets up every morning, works like I get up every morning. Like America actually does. We all get up and we work and do our jobs every single morning. And that's what Joe really embodies. And when he fought from Farrow and went to Chicago in June and fought on national television, nobody gave him a shot. They looked at him, look, he's a worker, he's a laborer, he's strong, but nobody gave him a shot against Farrow. He was a 15-1 underdog, a 20-1 underdog, you know, and he went into Chicago and shocked the world, really the boxing world. Shocked Farrow, that was his hometown in Chicago, and scored a sensational first round knockout. That was and Oscar was talking about his knockout power, his 18th knockout in 22 wins. It was his 16th win in a row. He's 22-1. And 7th out of 8 knockouts in his last 8 fights. He really works hard, all right? We're expecting an awful lot on December 17th. He's been working very hard. Jerry Capobianco is his trainer, Phil Capobianco. They work with him in the union and also in the boxing ring. But he's really plied his craft. He's really learned his craft. He can really punch.